Pocket Money Chapter 1 The Transfer Certificate. Andhavan was a politician in Nattam town. He had a big bungalow in the Chetty Street. His wife's name was Anduchelvi. He had two sons by name Tarun Kumar and Varun Kumar. Tarun Kumar was studying in Buddha Matriculation School in 9th grade in the year 1998. It was the month of August. A new student by name Sugveer joined the same class of Tarun Kumar. Tarun Kumar was not a good student in studies. He failed in all subjects. His interests were in sports and girls. But no girls showed interest in him as he was bad in studies and he was not fair. Hence he always not respected the anyone, and he was also not respected by the people in his class. The new student Sugveer one day talked to Tarun Kumar. Sugveer said, "Please change you, man." Tarun Kumar said, "What do I need to change?" Sugveer said, "Study well, don't misbehave with the girls." Tarun Kumar said, "I can take your advice, go and do your duty." Sugveer got disappointed with his speech. One day, the administrative officer of the school called Sugveer. Sugveer repeated in her room. The administrative officer said, "Sugveer, we have an emergency situation." Sugveer asked, "What kind of situation, madam?" She said, "You please take a list of the peoples who are misbehaving with girls." Sugveer said, "Why, madam?" She said, "We are about to remove them." Sugveer said, "Oh my God." She said, "Nothing wrong. It is good for our school." Sugveer said, "Okay, madam, I will prepare the list." Sugveer observed many peoples on that day in the school. He took a list of peoples who were misbehaving with girls. In that, the first name was Tarun Kumar. Sugveer went to the administrative officer in the evening. He handed over the list to the administrative officer. She said, "Well done, my boy." The management called the father, the mother of all the boys who were on the list of the school. There were hot arguments and fights. The administrative officer and headmistress were strict on dismissing the people. But many parents pleaded that it was a mid-year. The management decided to remove at least one guy who was top of all misbehaving students. The name selected was Tarun Kumar. They gave the transfer certificate and termination order immediately to his parents. Andhavan tried a lot to convince the headmistress, but it was of no use. That day evening, Andhavan scolded at Tarun Kumar. Tarun Kumar did not have any guilty feeling. The next day, Andhavan tried with some other schools to join him. He found a government school for him. Tarun Kumar got a seat in that school. Chapter 2 The Summer Vacation. Tarun Kumar got new friends who were far worse than his previous friends. Mugilan and Chitraguptan were two of them. They had the habit of drinking beer at that age. Daily evening, they made Tarun Kumar drink with them. After drinking, they would make him eat snacks to reduce the beer's odor. The parents were unaware that Tarun Kumar had again fallen into the hands of a bad company, whereas Tarun Kumar was enjoying his days with them. It was a summer vacation in April 1999. The day was April 27th, which was a Tuesday. Morning at 7 o'clock, Tarun Kumar got a phone call. Tarun Kumar answered it. "Hello." The other end said, "This is Chitraguptan." Tarun Kumar said, "Yes, Chitraguptan, good morning." Chitraguptan said, "We have an outing today, man." Tarun Kumar asked, "Where have you planned?" Chitraguptan said, "It is to the Kolava Lake, man." Tarun Kumar said, "Oh, Kolaya Lake, do you know swimming?" Chitragupthan said, "I am learning, man." Tarun Kumar said, "I am a good swimmer, man." Chitragupthan said, "Okay, be at the spot by 10 o'clock. Tarun Kumar said, "Okay, sure, bye." Chitragupthan said, "Okay, bye." Tarun Kumar had a breakfast with his family. Anbaran asked, "What are you going to do today?" Tarun Kumar said, "We are going to play cricket, daddy." Anbaran said, "If I hear any problem about you, I will not leave you." Tarun Kumar said, "No, daddy, I am not involved in any mischief nowadays." They completed their breakfast. Tarun Kumar was about to leave the home. Anbaran called him, "Stop, my son." Tarun Kumar asked, "What, daddy?" Anbaran hugged him and said, "I am sorry, my son. I can't help you in that school issue." Tarun Kumar said, "It is okay, daddy, no problem." Anbaran took 2 500 rupee notes and gave it to Tarun Kumar. Anbaran said, "Here, take this as your pocket money for today." Tarun Kumar opened his mouth wide. "What? 1,000 rupees as a pocket money for today?" Tarun Kumar was happy. He got the amount and came out of his house. Tarun Kumar took his bike and went to Kolava Lake. His friends Mugilan and Chitragupthan were there as planned. Tarun Kumar said, "Good morning, guys." Mugilan said, "Good morning, man." Chitragupthan said, "Good morning." Tarun Kumar said, "Guys, today I am going to give you a treat." Mugilan asked, "How?" Tarun Kumar said, "I have got 1,000 rupees as a pocket money." Mugilan said, "Oh my god." Tarun Kumar gave ₹500 to Chitragupthan and said, "Come on, go and buy us a beer." Mugilan said, "No, man, we are going to swim. We will have it in the evening." Tarun Kumar said, "Oh, you fool. I am Tarun Kumar, son of the politician and baron." Chitragupthan said, "Yes, we are strong people, man." Chitragupthan went to the wine shop and brought beer for them. They drank the beer in the midst of the bushes which were present in the lake's shoreside. Three people were not in their senses. Tarun Kumar asked, "Hey, Mugilan, do you know swimming?" Mugilan said, "I don't know." Chitragupthan said, "I know somewhat." Tarun Kumar said, "You should see my swimming heroism." By saying that, Tarun Kumar removed his shirt and pant. With only his underwear, he jumped into the lake. Due to the alcoholic absence of mind, he was not able to swim. His limbs were moving here and there. Mugilan and Chitragupthan, on seeing that, they were laughing. "Ha ha ha ha, ha 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 ha, is this your swimming heroism?" But he was actually struggling in the lake for his life. Mugilan and Chitragupthan did not realize the fact which was happening there. He struggled on the surface of the water for 60 seconds and after that he got submerged into the water. Water entered into his lungs and choked him. The death happened to Tarun Kumar. The body floated in water for some time and it sank down. Mugilan and Chitragupthan then only realized it. Oh, until then they were thinking that he was playing for fun. But later they realized that it was a death. Mugilan shouted, "Oh my god, death man!" Chitragupthan yelled, "Yes man! We have to inform somebody." At that time, some people who were traveling on the nearby road spotted these two people yelling. They came running toward them. But before they could reach there, everything was over. Police got informed and Anbaran was also informed. The lake shore got filled with people and police. The dead body of Tarun Kumar got recovered from the lake. The police officers made inquiry over the incident. At last, they included that it was the drinking habit which had been the reason for a death. If he had not been drunk, he could have swum well, said one of the police officers. Anbaran said, "Sir, I don't know that he had the habit of drinking beer." The police officer scolded him, "Sir, you are the parent. You need to be careful." unburdened, cried with pain in the heart. Chapter 3. The Insurance Agent. After 1 week of the incident, Unburden was sitting in his home. He was not able to go to his profession. Hence, he stayed at home for some days. Unburden's phone rang on that day. He answered, "Hello." The other end said, "Sir, I am Sharath, calling from Cat's Life Insurance." Unburden said, "What do you want?" Sharath said, "We give all kind of accidental death cover policies." Unburden cried, "My son is dead. I don't need any policies." Sharath said, "Sir, I am sorry. How did your son die?" Unburden said, "He drowned in water." Sharath asked, "Why, sir? He doesn't know swimming?" Unburden said, "No, he knew swimming." Sharath said, "Then how did he die?" Unburden said, "He was drunk at that time and he jumped into the water." Sharath asked, "Who got him drinks at that time?" Unburden said, "Tarun's friend." Sharath asked, "Who gave them the money?" Unburden said, "It was Tarun Kumar, for whom I gave the pocket money." Sharath asked, "Pocket money? How much did you give?" Unburden said, 1,000 rupees. Sharath said, "Oh my God, the 1,000 rupees of pocket money has taken the life of a person." Story ends. It is a habit that some of the parents give their children a good amount of pocket money when they are going out, but they always are not being careful in what they give to their children, and they are not at all conscious that what is happening to their children. This pocket money of rupees 1,000 given to Tarun Kumar has taken his life. So this is a lesson to be learnt from this story. Thank you.